June of 2011, the M.A.R.C. Center opened its doors to the community. The purpose behind the M.A.R.C. was we as a community had found that we had a lot of good services in place for youth that were already in the system or entering the system, but we had a bit of a gap in our services for those youth that had not entered the system yet or some of the ones that were on the cusp of coming into the system. So it was a collaboration between the Calcasieu Parish Police Jury and the Children Youth Planning Board. They came up with the idea of the M.A.R.C. Center. The philosophy behind the M.A.R.C. is if we are able to work with families at the brink of an issue starting to take root, and we're able to link them with good community supports to help with those issues, to treat what some people would call the maladaptive behaviors and put in some more pro-social type coping mechanisms in place, that we hope that the families will get what they need and be able to be successful on their own without any system involvement. The M.A.R.C. operates off of two principles to accomplish this. Number one is we want to assess families and link them with community supports that best meet their needs and allow them to be part of the decision making with that. We provide them with options and then they could choose the one that's best for them. The second fold is to ensure that they have timely access to these services. So we feel like the sooner we can get them into services, the sooner we can treat the issue, the less likely it is to take root and the more options or opportunities these families have to be happy, healthy, and successful, what we would want for our own children. Over the years, the M.A.R.C. has had the opportunity to evolve. In the beginning, it was primarily set up to be a support for law enforcement. So what that means is that law enforcement would arrest a youth for a minor offense in the community, and then they could be transported to the M.A.R.C. We would screen and assess the youth and link them with the supportive services they need. The way I'm very proud to say that we have evolved, and the one thing that Calcasieu Parish does a lot of other jurisdictions does not, is the parish allows us to work with youth that are not involved in the system. So we can use the same screening mechanisms, the same principles that we do with a youth that is referred formally by law enforcement or the school system, and we can provide those supports to families by them simply walking into the M.A.R.C. No appointment necessary. They can come in at any time when they feel like they're in crisis or need support, whatever level of crisis that may be at, we can assist them and help them to move forward. So with that, in turn, law enforcement in the school system has also caught on to this and realized that this is a great opportunity to get families help before they have to become formally involved. So now let's say a law enforcement officer goes out to the home and a youth is exhibiting some behaviors that are very concerning, but it is not a legal issue. That law enforcement officer can in turn refer the family to the M.A.R.C. Center. He can let the parents know this is not enough to formally charge youth, but I do see that you need some assistance. I would recommend that you go to the M.A.R.C. Center. With that, in turn, we have had a substantial increase in number of walk-ins that we are able to provide support to over the years. And the good thing about that is it's the old adage of if you provide someone with a support, they will use it. We found that if we give families the opportunities, they are going to take advantage of them. They want things to go well. They want to be happy, healthy, and successful. If we can provide them with the right opportunity to guide them in the right direction, they can normally take the plan or the support that we've identified that they need, and they can run with it, and they don't need us anymore in their lives. But if they ever do need that support again, they also leave knowing that they can return to the M.A.R.C.
The M.A.R.C. Center really came from an idea from the Children Youth Planning Board, and there was holes in the juvenile justice system where like law enforcement would have a young person for not necessarily a child going to detention, but for a misdemeanor or some type of, you know, light crime, and they wouldn't know what to do with them because it would be after hours. So they would end up having to babysit, you know, a child for 6-7 hours until they found a parent. And so by the same token, as like schools in crisis areas, you know, out there, they would have problems and they wouldn't know what to do with kids in crisis. And we were only open 8 to 5 in our intake program. And so through the Children Youth Planning Board, we figured we could kind of extend our hours and open up it's a kind of a crisis center, you know, for children that are in crisis and assist law enforcement for those misdemeanor offenses that didn't necessarily need to go to detention. And so that's how the thought or the concept was, is to assist law enforcement and to assist the community by extending the hours and giving them somebody to talk to when they are in crisis. And you know, crises occur not just during 8 to 5, not just Monday through Friday. So the powers that be said we would extend the hours and we would extend the day. and it has taken off like gangbusters. The staff over here is tremendous. We hired Josh as the MARC manager, and he has done a super job. And really, the MARC has done what we had wanted to do by serving the community.
There has been a significant change in our abilities to better support youth and families in the community. Our hours of operation were 8 a.m. to 11 p.m. Monday through Saturday. With the support of the community, we are now extending those hours to, it'll start on Sunday, 1 p.m. to 11 p.m. Monday and Tuesday, we will be open from 8 a.m. to 2 a.m. And Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, we will be open 8 a.m. to 4 a.m. We feel this will better meet the needs of the community and better meet the needs of the families. We are extending our opportunity to be there as a support in their times of crisis and also to support law enforcement. Part of what we want to do at the MARC is we want to intervene and we want to take that burden or that extra stressor off of law enforcement. They have a lot to do in the community. They have to keep us safe and they have many other obligations. If there's a crisis in the home and that is something that the MARC can assist with, we want them to contact us before they would contact law enforcement. If it's an emergency, yes, contact law enforcement, but if it's something that you need assistance with, a crisis or something that's you could see escalating, come to us. There are multiple ways that a youth and a family can come into the MARC Center for Services. One of the primary ways is through law enforcement involvement. What that would mean is that a youth was out in the community, law enforcement identified them to be doing something that was either a offense as a status offense or a delinquency. That law enforcement officer would call us by phone with the officer at the time of the call, and we would let that officer know whether that youth would be able to be transported to the MARC Center if it was a low-grade misdemeanor offense or status offense, or if it was a felony offense that maybe that youth may have to go to the detention center for a secondary screening. Once law enforcement arrived, they would go through what we call our law enforcement back door. That is a secure area where we house youth until the parents get here and we can start the intake process. The primary reason for that secure area is because those youth are in our custody and we want to make sure they remain safe until that parent comes here that we can transfer custody back to that parent. Once the parent gets here, we explain opportunities that we have that we can try to assist the family with, and one of those opportunities is to divert that youth from formal case processing or having to go to court. If the family accepts, then we would reunite the youth and the family, we would explain everything to them, and the process would start immediately. When I say immediately, the youth would be placed on what we call the JIF screening tool. That's the Juvenile Inventory for Functioning. It goes over different life domains, and what it tries to do is identify issues by the youth self-reporting that we may need to look to put supports into place for. So let's say the youth has identified that he may be using substances. Well, we can look to link them with community supports to address that issue and to help them to find healthier coping skills and mechanisms to keep them from using substances. Once all that is done, and part of that plan with linking them is we sit down with the family. So we're not just going to say, we want your child to go to this service. We're going to give them an opportunity to look at the services that are in the community, and we want that family to be part of the decision making. They're going to be in the driver's seat the entire time. That is our goal. Those closest to the problem are closest to the solutions, and we firmly believe that families hold all the resources and strengths they need to be successful. Sometimes they just need to be guided in the right direction. So when all is said and done, a plan will be put in place of the family's agreement, and we're very optimistic at that point. If we can follow through with that plan and things go well, that youth may not enter into the system or penetrate any deeper into the system. And also, we are there to support them for months after that intake process has happened, and if they need, we need to look to retune or look for other services that may support them better. If they feel like their needs aren't being met, we're there to guide them through that process also.
What we wanted to do is be a place for parents to come when they didn't have anything else, kind of like if they were looking for answers, we could give them answers for their children and for children that are in crisis. Sometimes parents just don't know what to do. And we have two ways of doing it, is that there's formal court processing and there's informal. And most of the referrals that come through are informal court processing. And that's what we wanted it to do, is to be a respite and a kind of an answer area for kids that are in crisis. So when we identify these problems, they don't come back. Recidivism is measured in so many ways. I mean, it really is. And right now, what we're identifying now is that the kids that are in our diversion program have about a 98% success completion rate. Now, do they come back? Some do, and we're studying that. But the ones that we have in our diversion program right now, and that's a diversion from our district attorney's office and our office that we keep in programs and not formally go to court, is I think like 97.8%. It's like really 98%. And that's just, that's remarkable.
When the MARC was first created, the age range we were looking at was from 5 years old to 17. But I will say that the parish allows us to work with families. Sometimes the youth will come at a younger age. Now, it's not necessarily youth that needs support when they come in at that younger age. It may be the parents that need support. Maybe they're having some difficult times of knowing what type of skills to use to best redirect their youth, or maybe they're having some stressors that are coming from being this new parent. I know whenever I first went through parenting, I had those stressors. We want to be a support, and we can link those families with those community supports that can meet their needs. Also, if someone comes in at an age above 17, we could still work with them in what we call our status offender program to the age of 18. But even after 18, if a family comes in and they're having issues, we may not have any, per se, in-house services that we can provide them, but there's still a lot of community supports out there that we can link them to. So we never want to turn anyone away. The parish has even afforded us the opportunity to work with youth that are out of parish. So if a family would come in, let's say from Jeff Davis Parish, or they would come in from one of our outlying parish, other parishes, we can support them. We may be limited in what we can do, but because we have to link them with supportive services outside of our parish, but we help them through that process. One interesting story is about 3 years ago, we had a youth come through from Jeff Davis Parish that needed assistance. And they came through to MARC, and we identified the issues that we felt like we may need to address. And the mother was so adamant to get the services that we had in-house at the parish that the family actually moved from Jeff Davis Parish to Calcasieu Parish. That is not something that we assume will happen all the time, but it was a good feeling to know that we're doing something right as a community here, that people would actually want to move into our community to get the services that we are able to provide.
DCFS comes in here, Children and Family Services, they come in here a lot. ETC, Family and Youth, Choices, which is a wraparound service. We're getting some emails just the other day about a tutoring service through McNeese that they want to come in and they want to tutor children, at-risk children. I use at-risk, you know, because that's the term that people know, but I don't like the term because I think all of our children are at risk. They'll come in here for tutoring, and we're going to be opening that sometime this fall. McNeese and I think the Literacy Council are the ones that are pushing this, and they want to have an area after hours. We're going to be open, and so certainly we have the space. Anybody that is a parent out there or is a caretaker of a child knows sooner or later your buttons are going to get pushed. I mean, that's just the way it goes. I mean, we've all had teenagers. Or most, and sooner or later, that teenager is going to push our buttons. Sometimes it's a little bit more than that parent is equipped to handle. Sometimes they're really looking for some help, some solutions. And although we're not a mental health agency, what we do is we identify the problem. And they might come in here with a problem because they haven't done their homework. And then we'll put them on the GIF and figured out that they hadn't done their homework because their reading level is at a third grade level. And so a child that is in the seventh grade that's reading on a third grade level obviously is going to have problems in school. And nobody might have ever tested them on that. And so through our assessment, we can identify exactly what the problems are within the family unit and be able to get them the services that they need for them to be successful. And do we do it here? No, we're not a mental health agency, but we have so many community partners out there that we can pick up the phone and call Family and Youth or ETC or whatever one of the counseling agencies that are out there and say, okay, we have a child that we really think could benefit from your services. This family could benefit. And then we have contracts out there with some of these partners as well that we can refer directly to them at no cost to the family.
The Bay's families would reach us if they needed the services or to initiate support would be, they can call the MARC number. The primary number is 337-721-3971. Or if they would like to come in at their convenience with no appointment necessary, our address is 3581 East Prion Lake Road. I want to take this moment to make sure families realize that this is a safe place for them to come when they need assistance. There's no problem too big or too small. We're here to help. This is not going to be a judgment zone. We understand that everyone has issues that they're dealing with. We want a family to come in, know they're going to be welcomed, and know that they will leave with maybe everything won't be perfect when we walk out the door, but we will be on the right path to getting that family to where they want to be, which is ultimately where we want our own children and our lives to be, for us to have opportunities to be happy, healthy, and successful.